Seder. I'm a member of the Night Kol Yoke, and I'm excited to share with you the Dvar Torah on Parshas Vayeitzei. In this week's parasha, we learn about the birth of many of the Shvatim, and Leah has four sons. First, Reuven, Shimon, Levi, and then by Yehuda, the Pasuk explains to us why she named him Yehuda. And in Perek Chavtes, Pasuk Lamed Hei, the Pasuk explains that she named him Yehuda based off that Hapam Odes Hashem. At this time, she thanked Hashem. And Rashi and the Menevra explain that what was unique about this time that she thanked Hashem? Because there were four wives of Yaakov, each one was allowed to get three of the Shvatim, totaling 12 Shvatim. Yet this was Leah's fourth son, so she was getting more than what she was allotted for, more than her share. And so she said, Hapam Odes Hashem, this time I'm going to be especially thankful to HaKadosh Baruch Hu for receiving more than what was meant to come to me. The Gemara in Brachos says on Daf Zayin Amud Beis that when Leah thanked Hashem, this was the first time anyone ever thanked HaKadosh Baruch Hu. And Rav Schwab is bothered by this Gemara. How could it be that this thinking of Leah was the first time? Adam, Noach, Avram, Yitzchak, Yaakov, no one ever thanked Hashem until Leah had Yehuda, and then she said, Hapam Odes Hashem, this time I'm going to thank Hashem. How could that be? How is that possible? Schwab therefore explains a deeper and different understanding. He says that we know that Leah's first three children, Reuven, Shimon, and Levi, they were all named because of her feelings that she felt that she was secondary to Rachel. We know that Yaakov loved Rachel more than he loved Leah, and Leah felt it, and therefore she named the children in a way that represented that secondary nature that she had in her relationship with Yaakov. And when she was having a fourth child, she realized that even as much as I want and I'm desirous of my husband and I'm hoping that the relationship's going to change, it hasn't changed. It's still the same. But yet, I'm still going to thank Hashem even in a situation which I don't view as ideal, a situation that I don't want it to be that way. Still, I'm going to thank Hashem for the goodness of my life. And that type of thank you was what we never found in creation until Leah thanked HaKadosh Baruch Hu. And it's a lesson, it's a challenge for us, that when we find ourselves in situations which we're davening for it to be differently, we're hoping, we're doing as much as we can to make the situation different, but we still find ourselves in a situation which is not ideal, not the way we want it to be able to say, Hapam Odes Hashem, I'm still going to find the good in life, and I'm still going to thank HaKadosh Baruch Hu. That's our challenge, that's our mission, and if we can do that, we can be like Leah, to thank HaKadosh Baruch Hu in a way that not everyone else is able to do. Have a great Shabbos. Thank you.